Our next story can be summed up with a Wikipedia page. Let me show you what it looks like. Catholic Church sexual abuse cases. That's right, an entire Wikipedia page is dedicated to sexual abuse by the church. Tells you how big the problem is. Everyone knows about it. The Pope, the bishops, the parishioners, everybody. Then how do so many priests get away with it? Because the church covers it up. They silence survivors, they block investigations, they hide these crimes until they're too big to cover up. That's what happened in France. Investigators found that 300,000 children, 300,000, had been sexually abused by the clergy. Who are the perpetrators here? Men of God, trusted lieutenants of the Catholic Church. Clearly, the system is broken. The church is tormenting the same people it is supposed to serve. What does Pope Francis plan to do? He started off with an apology. He says this is a moment of shame for him, for Catholics, and for the church.
I wish to express to the victims my sadness and pain at the trauma they have suffered, and also my shame. Our shame, my shame at the church, who for too long failed to consider their concerns as it should have. I offer them my prayers. I pray, and together we all pray. To you, Lord, the glory, to us, the shame. This is the time for shame.
Now, I know what you're thinking. Wow, an apology from the Pope. Surely the church will reform itself now. Well, think again. Pope Francis is not the first to apologize for sexual abuse crimes. That would be Pope John Paul II. He apologized way back in 2001. He said sexual abuse was a profound contradiction to the teachings of Jesus. Then came Pope Benedict XVI. He apologized in 2008. 10 years later, his successor, Pope Francis, has also apologized. You see, this has become a pattern. The church is implicated in horrendous crimes. There is international outrage. The Pope apologizes, and then we move on. But what next? Where are the reforms? These abuse cases are not isolated incidents. The church consistently puts itself above survivors. In April this year, a group of United Nations experts sent a letter to the Vatican. This is what they wrote. The experts noted the persistent allegations of obstruction and lack of cooperation by the Catholic Church with domestic legal proceedings. They also noted the concordats and other agreements negotiated by the Holy See with states that limit the ability of church authorities to question and compel the production of documents or prosecute people associated with the Catholic Church. This is classic obstruction of justice. The church is basically protecting sexual predators. It is denying justice to thousands of abuse survivors. And this is becoming the Vatican way. Whether it's legal cases, financial dealings, or political reforms, there is no transparency in the Catholic Church. And remember, we're not talking about some privately held company. This is the Catholic Church. It has 1.3 billion followers in the world. Transparency is non-negotiable. The question is, how can it be achieved? This is a 2,000-year-old institution. It is programmed to resist change. Only one person can possibly make a difference, and that's the Pope himself. Pope Francis has unveiled a new plan for the church, a 2-year consultative process. It has 3 steps. Number one, the listening phase, where parishioners can discuss a wide range of topics in their local church. Number two is the continental phase, where bishops will gather and discuss what they heard at their church. And step number three is the universal phase, where bishops will meet at the Vatican for a month-long meeting. And this meeting is scheduled for October 2023. It's 2 years away. Again, it sounds like great news. They're finally doing something. But the Pope has a condition. Discuss all you want, but the final decisions lie with me. Well, what's the point then? The Catholic Church needs a major overhaul, and it must start at the top. You cannot function like a secret society in 2021. You must be transparent. You must embrace change. And for that, the Pope must take responsibility. He must stop obstructing investigations. He must disown sexual predators. And he must put the rule of law above image building. The time for apologies has passed. The church must act now or risk backlash from its own followers. Vyond is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.